thank you for coming to my session. This session title is ED Contributable Internationalization Process with Sphinx. At first, let me introduce myself. My name is Takayuki Shimizukawa. Came from Japan. I do three open source works. One is a Sphinx core maintainer since the end of 2011, and organized Sphinx user group in Japan. It's a regional user group. And third, member of PyCon JP committee. And I'm working for a B-Plus company. We develop web application for business customers by using Django and Pyramid. And before my main presentation, I'd like to introduce PyCon JP 2015 in Tokyo, Japan. We will hold the event in this October. Registration is open. Unfortunately, Arrival ticket has been sold out. And we are looking for session speakers, and the CFP is open until July 15th. Please join us and please apply for your proposal. This is the agenda of the session, of this session. A Sphinx introduction and the setup for IATM, and an easy way and non-easy way to translate. A Sphinx IATM feature. And both automated translation process with several services. And finally, tips, tracks, and traps. Before proceeding the subject, I want to ask, how many people do you use open source software? How many people do you using open source? Oh, not all. Okay, thank you. Maybe 10 people. Most people are using. And how many people may have contributed to the OSS? Contributing? Two. Thanks. It's very small number, but thanks. In my opinion, using open source software is also the first contribution. And also we can say that introducing the OSS to other people is another contribution. So, almost people who have raised your hands the first is already contributing to the OSS, in my opinion. And last question, many of the open source software provides a document in English? And how do you think, does the translation into familiar language contribute to other developers? Yes, thanks. In Japan case, many programmers are familiar to English. Then in such situation, translated document helps me when I introduce some library to other developers. Because of this, I occasionally translate documents. I think by your translation of the OSS document, more people will be able to use the OSS. And if more than one person can join such translation work easily, it would be great. In this session, I'll introduce how to make a mechanism which is easy to join as a translator. In order to make the mechanism, we will use such tools and services in this session. Tools are Sphinx docutils, Sphinx INTL, and Transfix client. And services, Transfix and drone.io. First subject, I will introduce the Sphinx introduction and set up Sphinx for IATM. What is Sphinx? Sphinx is a documentation generator. Sphinx generates docs as several output formats from text markup. This blue box is a Sphinx, and Sphinx read restructured text format and output several, like HTML and PDF and EPUB, so on. This man, Gerald Randall, is the father of Sphinx. Until 2007, Python official document was written by LaTeX, but it's too hard to maintain us. Then Gerald was trying to change such situation. So then he created the Sphinx in 2007. The Sphinx provides ease of use and maintainability for the Python official document. Nowadays, many docs are written by Sphinx as you see. For example, these library and tools are using Sphinx, Python, and Sphinx, and Flask, Jinja 2, Django, Pyramid, SQL Alchemy, NumPy, SciPy, Scikit-learn, Pandas, Fabric, Ansible, AWS CLI, CLS, AWS CLI, so on. And especially these library tools are generating documents from source code by using Sphinx. And non-Python library tools also using Sphinx. I pick up the names Chef, Chef, CakePHP, and MathJax, Selenium, and Vanish. Relation between Sphinx and DocUtils. Sphinx is created in 2000 based upon DocUtils library. This part is a DocUtils, and this blue large part is a Sphinx. DocUtils and Sphinx supports restructured text. It's called REST, usually. It's an extensible markup rather than Markdown or some other wiki-like markups. Comparing DocUtils and Sphinx, DocUtils handle single page, and Sphinx can handle multiple pages. DocUtils can link to other pages with full name include extension as like as .html, and Sphinx can connect to other pages with Sphinx can connect all pages and single tree structures by using talktree directive. Sphinx notation. And DocUtils can make cross reference in a page, and Sphinx can make cross reference over each other pages without extension like .html. And DocUtils provides writers. By default is HTML, LaTeX, NaN, XML, so on. And Sphinx also provides them, and Sphinx will provide additional writers, HTML with theme, themas, and PDF, and tech info, and EPUB, so on. And DocUtils can handle standard restructured text markup spec. It's a different implementation of a restructured text. And Sphinx will provide additional markup specs like autodoc directive and so on. Sphinx extends the IATN mechanism to provide translation feature. In this session, let's take a look at the IATN feature. How to install Sphinx with IATN tools? You need to install Sphinx to build a Sphinx document. Also, you need to install Sphinx INTL and Transfix client, these two tools, for translation. In my opinion, newest Transfix client is not stable, then I'm using Ottawa. At first, you should get source code, whether from GitHub or other press to translate it. In this case, the source code already has a Sphinx doc directory. And like this, git clone from blah blah, and cd to doc directory and make HTML. So I make HTML in doc directory to generate HTML output. You can see the output in build slash HTML directory. Like this is the output of the Sphinx document. Now you can see the directories and file structure like this. Target library for doc, target library for doc that is cloned from existing repository. Document build output. Document build output. That was generated by make HTML. And document source. This part, document source. And that was generated by Sphinx quick start command. This is conf.py that included the document source directory, and you should add these two lines to the conf.py. Line 3 in language equal mml. Sorry, I fix I wrote and you can choose your language code, and local DIRS variable have to have local directory to store the translation files. Now setup is over, and this. It is the main subject from here. Easy contributable internationalization process with Sphinx. What is internationalization? It's usually called IATM. And the internationalization process is sometimes called translation or localization enablement without rewriting the source code from a technical point of view. Without rewriting the source code from a technical point of view is important. What is easy contributable? Some software users or document readers have wanted to contribute by translation. But if the preparation of the translation takes a long time or requires many kinds of skills, they are frustrated and give up. Easy contributable is a state that will be accepted the contributions immediately. So for the comparison, I'll introduce the three cases of difficult to contribute. First one is the manual are provided only in the HTML files. Of course, you can translate it, but usually the HTML files are frequently updated. How do you follow the original changes to update your translations? This is the first case. I have no idea how to follow the original changes. Second example, when the manual are generated from restructured text files and doc strings in the source files, you can rewrite original files to translate it. But this approach has three problems. I think first one is you must be careful to maintain restructured text structure. And second one is it's hard to divide translation tasks for a number of volunteer translators. And third one is it's hard to pursue the upstream document source that is frequently updated. In the last example, we are engineers, then we can use Git. But learn Git and learn GitHub and Git Chrome to get the code and translation. I think this is what I want to do. And after that, Git commit, Git pull, sometimes resolve conflict, and Git push. Additionally, in this case, the repository owner should allow write access permission for each translator. This is also not an easy way. Well then, what is an easy way? My opinion is this. Left side is not an easy way, and right side is an easy way. We need an easy way. The combination of the Sphinx IATN feature and some of the service can realize such a mechanism. That's what is the goal of this session. I'll explain how to create the mechanism in this session. Third subject, Sphinx IATN feature. I'll explain the detail of the feature. Sphinx IATN feature is composed of two functions. First one is a generation POT file from restructured text file. POT file is a famous translation catalog for catalog format for Gettext that is used for IATN. A second feature is the generation translated HTML from is using a PO file and original restructured text file. A PO file is a translated version of catalogs. It's a human work to prepare the translated PO file from the POT file. Like this. Converting the POT file into a PO file, this part, a POT file to PO file is the job of a human. In this flow, author generates POT file at first part, and then author asks translator to translate them. Translators receive the POT file from author in some way, then translate them. Once it has been finished, translators send back the PO file to author. Let's look a little more detail from first part. Author can use make getText command to generate PO file, POT file, and make getText command extract text from restructured text file and Python source that referenced by autodoc feature. It means you can translate them into any language without rewriting the original restructured text file and Python source file. As you see, POT translation catalog, this is a POT translation catalog file, makes easy to translate from one language to another languages. Message ID line, the file have a message ID and message strings pairs. Message ID line have an original sentence, and message strings line will have translated one. It's empty because POT is a non-translation, and that doesn't have translated lines. Translated PO files should have a right side structure, this one. And local directory has a ZHCM, and it has a LC messages directory, and it has translated PO files. Sphinx generated POT files like this. And in this case, translator copy and rename POT files into such structures. When original POT files are updated by changing by of original document, you should update the PO file too. If you had done it manually, it's very hard. You can automate it by Sphinx INTL tool. This is a Sphinx INTL tool version's workflow. At first, Sphinx INTL copy POT files and rename them by this command. In this case, Sphinx INTL update -p is the POT files location, and hyphen L means translation. Translate. You want to translate language. Then this command copy POT files into the right place. Sphinx INT also updates different for each PO file when the document is changed. After document changes, you should run make Gettext again, and you can use Sphinx INTL tools as this. This command line is identical by previous one. Same line. As a consequence of introducing the Sphinx INTL tools, translators can concentrate for translation. This is a translation work. Translator can use their favorite editors or helpful tools or services. Easy that provide translation support feature like translation memory or recommendation, similar translation or glossary or auto translation by using like Google or Bing, Microsoft Bing. Once the translation is complete, finally let's run the make HTML command again. Like this. Finally, author and translator can run make HTML and can get translated output without editing restructured text and Python code. This is a translated HTML sample. This one. Oh, sorry. This is a before to translate PO file, and this is a translated one that have a translated line in Mandarin. And after that, make HTML generate a translated document like this. Internally, Sphinx pass restructured text file and replace them into translated one by using PO file. Entire process to translate Sphinx docs is this. If you translate some Sphinx document without using the IATN feature, you need to rewrite original document source files. The Sphinx INTL feature provides an easy way to translate a document as you see. Okay, let's show a demo. This is my command line, and Sphinx quick start and quick mode and author version project directory Sphinx IATN demo and Sphinx IATN demo and make HTML. This is a template, just template, then start Firefox to show build HTML index. Oh, sorry. Okay, this is just a template output, and the page has no. Presentation mode. This is a Sphinx index restructured text file, and I replace it by. Oh, thanks. Fukuakari. This is a research artist file and make HTML link. Okay, this is the output, first version of output. And make HTML, sorry, make Gettext to generate POT files. And the, finally, we get build Gettext directory that have index.pot file. Index.pot file have original version and empty translated lines. And we need to copy the POT file into other location properly. Then I will use Sphinx intl command to update POT files. POT files location is build Gettext directory and to ch underscore cn. I forgot the show conf.py file modification. I should add a locale, EIRs equal locale, and make HTML translate. Sphinx intl update command again. That command create a index.po file for what chcn language, and locale chcn have a index.po file that still empty, and we should translate it from prepared version. Okay, I can read this translated. But maybe, and make HTML with, make HTML suffix opt with hyphen language equal chcn. Code is can't decode. This language. In such case, I already created the POT file. Locale this message. And finally, maybe translate it.
Thank you. The mechanism of IATN of Sphinx. In both subjects, automated translation process with several services, we will continue to automate this mechanism. Right now, we have seen an overall picture of the process. Actually, I have things that was not pictured here. Yes, these commands such as make blah blah or Sphinx intl command require your hands to invoke. In other words, the translator must learn such steps. Additionally, it would be difficult to translate in parallel. It's not an easy way still until. Then, okay, let's make it to be automation and parallelization. And then the translation doesn't, translator doesn't need to know the mechanism and makes the translation work possible to parallelize. Let's take a look at from the parallelization of the translation work. Once you get PO files, you can use helpful tool service, easy, that provides translation support feature. And in particular, the use of the online translation service is important for parallelization. I'd like to introduce the Transfix as an online translation service. Transfix provides the following functions. As an API, upload POT and download PO, as a web console, glossary and translation memory and recommendations and auto translation. Auto translation is provided Google API or Microsoft API. Because you can do translation on the web screen, you can translate them with other translators in parallel. Translation on Transfix web console. I numbered this. Okay. Number one, you can select one untranslated message. These are message lines, and the lines have a original source and a translated source. And these three lines does not have a translated one. And number two, translate it by yourself or by machine translation. And if the message contains long module or method name, you can click the icon, this one, to copy original to the translation box without typing. And number four, this part is a recommendation. Sometimes you are suggested translation messages from other translator or translation memory. Translation memory called TM pick up suggestions from similar translation in the project or its historical changes. For example, when doc author fixes a typo, translation will be discarded. However, translation memory suggested previous translation that matches 99% with current original messages. Once you finish the translation, you can save it. Save button is here. And optionally, reviewer can review it. Review button is here. And you have made translation parallelization by using Transfix. Next, let's automate the central part, this part. Oh, sorry. Okay. The procedure you want to automate is made up of six steps. At first, we will review the six steps. First step is clone repository to be translated. And step two is make Gettext to generate a POT file. And third step is upload POT translation catalog source to Transfix. And step four is download translated PO files. And step five is make HTML with using original restructured text file and translate the PO file. And step seven is, step five is make HTML. And step six is upload HTML to publish it. That's all. Next, We will replace these all steps on the command line. This is a command line that includes steps. Line 1 is installing Sphinx related packages and git clone and cd doc directory. And line 4 is Sphinx intl another command, create transfix rc command. That creates a transfix rc, dot transfix rc file, and that has a username and password information. The Sphinx intl command picked up the information from environment like this. And line 5 is Sphinx intl command again to create trans txconfig file. Txconfig file pressed at .tx/config. It includes transfix server's information and resource information to upload the resources. And make Gettext and Sphinx intl update command generate the PO files. And TX push command to push POD files to transfix, and TX pull command to download PO files. And finally, make HTML command to generate, language equal VH underscore CM. Now we replace the 5 steps on the command line except HTML uploading part. I'll explain the part later. Other thing above, you can automate the process by this script. Rest of work is preparing an environment to run the script automatically. As one of the environments, I'll introduce the drone.io service. The drone.io is a continuous integration service. Drone integrates seamlessly with GitHub, Bitbucket, and Google code to make setup fast and simple. Drone also integrates with Amazon and Heroku, Google App Engine, and more. For custom deployments, you can use SSH and shell script. You can use the service for public project without charge. In my case, I usually use GitHub and S3 integration. Process of that is push notification from GitHub, and that involves a script using, and then deploy HTML to HTML files onto S3 storage. If you set webhook notification URL to transfix hook setting updating, update translations also involves the drone.io script. By using drone.io service, automation can be achieved. Upper left process is replaced with right down one. Webhook inbox the script automated by drone.io. Webhook from GitHub inbox the script, and the script executes command several commands. And finally, drone.io deployment feature will deploy HTML to AWS S3 storage. As this, we got the automated mechanism by using drone.io environment. In summary, let's look at the result of the automation at each point of view as author and translators. At first, point of view from the doc author. When author pushes to the repository, translation source of transfix will be updated, and author can check the translated live HTML in the site. Doc author doesn't require annoying procedures. The second is a point of view from doc translators. they can translate the document in parallel with no git, no file, no conflict. Translation source are updated automatically. And they can get the translated HTML output without hand build. It means that the translation contributors can focus on the translation. By the mechanism of automation, both of doc author and translators will provide the maximum effect with the minimum of effort. Okay, maybe time? Time up? Okay.
3 minutes.
Maybe? Okay. This is the tools at first I introduced. And tips. Okay, I'll skip this. And traps is, I said, transfer client. Latest version is not stable, I think. Tricks. I'll skip this. Sorry. Examples. I'll soon upload this presentation as the slide share, and please check the these URLs. These URLs have automated mechanism I introduced. Okay. That's all.